In self-defense, there's a big difference between being a protector and a punisher.
Today's video is brought to us by Firearms Legal Protection. Firearms Legal Protection is a legal defense program for lawful gun owners with a 24/7 emergency hotline and plans designed specifically for self-defenders. They are offering a discount on their plan to ASP fans, so hit the link in the description for that.
Welcome to today's active self-protection lesson. I'm your host, John Correa. Today's video comes to us out of Minas Gerais in Brazil, and it shows us a man who is absolutely justifiably angry at being the victim of an attempted mugging. So the guy walking at the top here is actually our perp, and you can see him looking around, doing some target glancing. He's got his hands in his pockets. Our victim's gonna come from the bottom of our screen here, and he's just apparently on his way to school. Dude's gonna pull a firearm and threaten him with it, and our victim's not having it and just goes to town, and now the fist fight starts and he knocks a guy out right there. Had to change sources on this one because the other one's blurted out. But now you're gonna see our victim is angry and he is gonna start absolutely head kicking this guy like nuts. Gets his phone out and is going to start live streaming it. And you can actually go and find some information on this one and see his live stream on it where he's yelling at him. That's how we do things around here. And come to find out, the pistol that the guy had was a fake airsoft gun. And now he's yelling at him and telling him that that's not what we do around here and kicking him in the head some more, a significant amount. Now, if you go read the news story in the description, the perp here who turned out and eventually to be a victim was treated at the hospital and released. I don't know if authorities ended up charging this guy. I can't really read through it in Portuguese, but if you know, let me know.
Boy, some serious stuff here for us to talk about. If you appreciate the lessons you get here every day at Active Self-Protection, do me a favor, hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss a lesson. Out of today's video, I want to think about the incredible importance of the 5Ds+1 when you're dealing with an armed attacker. Also, why I say empty-handed skills are so important. And we want to talk about that line that we might cross to be a legal self-defender and instead become an aggressor ourselves.
So let's think about as things get going here. Look at our perp here is starting his target glancing and looking around. Now, of course, you might just say, well, gosh, he's just looking about crossing the street. However, I do want to paint a total picture here and look from an awareness perspective that this guy's got his hands in his pockets. He's walking down the street. He's looking around, seeing what's going on. And you can tell by his body language that he's not getting from A to B. He's kind of loafing and trying to see what's going on and now vectoring across the street towards his intended victim. Now, if the victim is paying some significant attention, you could see right here that he's already going for this firearm that he has that is carried in his appendix. And notice there's some significant distance between the two of them here. So we say this all the time, attention buys you time and time buys you options. So if you're paying attention, maybe as a victim, you might have been able to stay left to bang on this one and gotten the heck out of there. Even so, if not, had he been carrying a firearm of his own, very difficult still in Brazil, he might have been able to get his out and into the gunfight here, but of course would have been, you know, he would have had to have been faster than him. Now, our victim is just not having it. You see the guy here comes up, he's threatening with the gun, starts to put his hand out on the victim, and the victim just reaches out and punches him right in the face. Now that said, I want to talk about the fact that I don't know if he knew at this point or could see at this point that this was a fake gun. And when somebody has a firearm on you, you have to practice the 5Ds+1 if you are unarmed yourself. Got to control the distance. He did a good job of that here. Got to deflect the muzzle. The muzzle is deflected here, but you got to dominate that firearm. You have to dominate that hand. And the reason that I say that, as it keeps on going, notice here he's able to bring that gun back around. Now we know, sitting here on the video, that that is fake, but I don't know that the victim knew that. And if that was a real gun, that bad guy brings that right back around and shoots him in the head, and this one ends very, very differently. So if you're gonna choose your empty-handed skills and you're gonna get after it, and I think empty-handed skills are important, you better practice those 5Ds+1, because if you forget dominate here, he brings that tool right back around and absolutely wrecks you with it. Now, once you dominate, then you have to distract and then disarm and then disable. Now, he gets into a pretty good fight here, and I do wanna say, you know, attitude is always more important than skills. Skills are more important than plan. Plan is more important than gear. But what we're gonna say here overall is if you look, he's leaving himself wide open. He's swinging his punches wildly. He's very angry, and I get that. But I want you to rise your level of skill set. I really want to encourage every single watcher of the channel to get to your empty-handed skills so that you are operating in a place of competence, not just anger, not just confidence, but competence and really getting after it, being able to have a high level of skills. Now, he got real lucky here, hit the guy on the button, and that easy button turned the guy off.
Now, I do want to say this. You notice the head kicks here, and that particular one wasn't even a defensive kick. That was a stomp on a downed opponent. You can see the guy's arms there. He is completely out. And friends, we got to talk here a little bit about the morality and the legalities of what he's doing. Now, I get it. He's angry. Dude has just pointed a gun at him. He has every right to be angry at him. Every right to be completely incensed at what this guy has done. But you can't become an aggressor, friends. You gotta make sure that you stay on the line of protection. When you're protecting yourself, when you're saying, listen, I'm trying to stop his aggression, totally okay. But when you cross the line into punishment, now you become an aggressor, can face legal consequences and moral consequences, because now he's got his phone out and he's starting to film the guy, and he's just kicking a downed opponent here who is absolutely no threat to him. Now, a couple problems with that. Number one, from a legal perspective, at this point, certainly in the United States, he would and could be charged with aggravated assault, because that could be serious, grievous bodily harm all day long. Kicking somebody with a shod foot who is down and defenseless, clearly aggravated assault here. Even from a tactical perspective though, you don't know if that dude's got buddies around. You don't know what else is going on in your world. You want to get the heck out of there. So this is ill-advised legally. It's ill-advised morally. It's also ill-advised tactically. You want to make sure that you are getting the heck out of there. And again, from a moral perspective, you got to be able to turn off that predator drive, that punishment urge, and instead get after getting yourself to safety. Now, what we see our original victim who's become an aggressor here doing is now he's got his cell phone out, and now he is live streaming that this guy's a piece of crap and that he's earned, and that's not how we do things around here, and now he's holding it over him. And friends, I'm going to tell you, a prosecutor in the United States is going to use that video as evidence of mens rea in this particular time. And by that, I mean an evil mind. Somebody who is intent on humiliating, intent on punishing. And that is not your role. Your role is not as punisher. There's a reason that the punisher worked outside of the law and was sought by the law. And I don't want you to be that. And this kind of action here turns him from being a victim to being an aggressor himself. He has lost the moral high ground. He has lost his innocence here, and he himself has become an aggressor. So I think there's some lessons here about the 5Ds+1, about some significant lessons here about having a robust, empty-handed skill set, some lessons here about awareness, but most importantly, there are some significant lessons here about being a good, sane, sober, moral person to do the right thing to protect yourself and nothing more to cover your ass.